So the most obvious fear is of options being removed, possibilities being taken, potential cut short. This desire they have to keep avenues open manifests in many ways in their life, all the way from the day-to-day and the mundane to the philosophical and the abstract. One of the ENTP's biggest strengths is that they are very versatile and adaptable. In a sense, it's their competitive advantage. The more fluid and changing an environment or setting is, the more they feel they can navigate and outmaneuver people around them. They will even, under certain circumstances, decide to completely shake things up for this reason. They have this strange comfort in chaos, attraction to the unknown. They fear order, structure, rigidity, the known and the predictable, or at least they fear being trapped by those things. They can tolerate them in short bursts, but when it becomes a long-term prospect, they will choose flexible danger over committing to safety, being unappreciated. Now, I could easily have said fear of being disliked, which I think is actually very true for ENTPs, since there's that joy they get in satisfying their extroverted feeling. Anytime they get to use it effectively will give them an immense amount of pleasure. But being disliked is kind of a generic fear. So instead, I decided to go with being unappreciated. As the saying goes, genius needs an audience. And so do ENTPs. They like to not only be creative and ideational, but also to be seen, to have those qualities, and I'd even say admired and respected for them. Yes, they are NT types, so they can be nerdy and intellectual, but as the many accusations of being know-it-alls or show-offs can attest to, I see them as being performers, mental performers, in every sense of that phrase. Intellectual acrobats that flaunt and flex their brain power in the same way an athlete would with their body. The thought of having no one that can appreciate or even just enjoy the things they have to offer is, I think, very frightening to ENTPs. They need other people to bounce off. They need feedback. They need an audience. People often say that ENTPs are very compatible with INTJs and INFJs. Now, I can see why that would be the case, because both INFJs and INTJs can appreciate what the ENTP is bringing, as well as being able to keep up with them in the intuitive, abstract realm. ENTPs are showmen and show women. And regardless of whether the tickets are expensive or it's free entry, the audience is essential. Sweating the small stuff. ENTPs have an imbalance in their life where they are very big picture orientated. As a result, the small, more minor details kind of get either neglected or disrespected. Just like with ENFPs, the idea that a small, precise detail could disrupt one of their grand plans is very disturbing. So imagine you're filling out a tax return, which is quite a big leap of imagination for some of us. And there's this one small box that has to be filled out in a certain way. And if you don't fill it out right, the entire form is void and invalid. Now, an ENTP would look at that system and think, the fact that it hinges on and can fall apart as the result of such a small and insignificant detail is a sign of how badly designed that system is. They kind of see small details as optional extras rather than essential things. I think it can be a source of pain and, yes, even fear, because so much of life seems to have become very bureaucratic and wrapped up in a nice bow of red tape. And there are many situations, sadly, where you can get into a lot of trouble for not paying attention to some very small, easily missable detail. You are a man without honour. Catelyn Stark. Okay, so here's an interesting one. In the Socionics typing system, ENTPs and ESTPs have FI polar, meaning it's kind of the worst function for them. Now, in my own way of describing the functions, I often equate FI to individuality, and along with that can come personal values, things that are important to you just because they are, without the need to justify them using logic, or TI, or utility and usefulness, TE. ENTPs struggle with this idea. In Game of Thrones, there's a motif that constantly reoccurs, and that is, if you decide to adopt rigid and unbending principles, you will almost certainly have to die or be killed for them at some point. as the saying goes, they are sometimes, literally, the hill you choose to die on. Then, on the other hand, characters whose principles can bend to suit the ebb and flow of events often survive. The more morally flexible types, whose allegiance is changeable, don't suffer the same gruesome fates. Now, I'm not saying that ENTPs are in the latter category, but they can be the best at it if they choose to be. Seeing multiple options in all situations and scenarios, never settling on one immutable set of principles or values that could become suddenly outdated. ENTPs enjoy this about themselves, but I think, and yes, I'm finally getting to a point here, that they also kind of fear this about themselves as well. They fear what they are capable of, and worry that they won't ever stand for anything. Of course, ENTPs stand for things. All sorts of freedoms, especially, I've noticed, freedom of speech. ENTPs are principled, but it's usually because they have a logical reason to be that way, and they can almost always see the opposite view of their own, and argue it very well. I think they have a fascination with people who believe in things just because they do. Maybe, and to be honest, this is more speculation than observation, there's a secret desire to know what it's like to turn off their usual chameleon-esque ability to match any background or setting and survive and even thrive and rise to the top, but instead to pick a colour and stick to it just because, to inevitably find that eventually you are perched on your branch in stark contrast to your surroundings, completely visible and open to attack, thinking, who gives a fuck? Speaking of picking colours and sticking to them, we have lots of colours to choose from in our typology-themed mugs we've designed. You'll find these advertised in a banner underneath our videos, or there'll be a link in the description. Also, feel free to check out our Patreon, where you can do lots of weird and wonderful things. And my final message to ENTPs, when you click that subscribe button, remember, you can back out anytime.